We have a really great mission statement that all of our girls know, and we say it aloud, but I'm not going to do that. Instead, I'm going to tell you it's going to cover four things, okay? Leadership, wellness, of course, going to college, and then service to others. So we really want our girls to become global citizens of the universe.
My dad told me that okra should be the good choice to put in the garden because okra is a very good plant to prevent from cancer.
The Ann Richards School for Young Women Leaders encourages project-based learning, like Project Ventura, where 7th grade science and 10th grade engineering students collaborated in a real-life product. Their mission? To give back to their teachers with a solar-powered lounge and garden.
It's a 1977 Airstream, and it came to us completely gutted, so they had to create all of the furniture and the inside and the interior. They interviewed all the teachers and found out what they wanted from their teacher's lounge and what they wanted it to look like. And then they had to build the furniture, and they started doing that with 3D modeling software. So they actually built all the furniture and designed it all on the computers, and then we went forward and actually built everything in the trailer.
By researching renewable energy, they captured the sun that fuels the garden into the Airstream's power strips.
They had to figure out the entire AC-DC conversion system and the inverter and how much power it would supply and what kind of appliances it would provide power to.
With a grant to purchase decomposed granite and rocks, the 7th grade science team installed a patio as part of their garden design. Then, the 10th graders built a porch to extend lounging time outside.
And it gave an opportunity for the 10th graders and 7th graders to interact, and the 10th graders to become role models.
And what's a garden without a picnic table? It wasn't a picnic to revive the worn-out discard, but helping hands restored it to al fresco magnificence.
It was just a contribution that everybody did, and it was really cool. Like, the 10th graders built the trailer, all the classes, you know, would work on, you know, separate parts, and we're all just working as a good community.
So the really wonderful thing about having a 6 to 12 school here is that the girls come in loving math and science, and then they see their big sisters do things like this trailer. So it makes it very real world for them that that's where my math and science and my engineering and my art is headed, to real life projects.
You kind of have to, like, cooperate more because you gotta have the same idea on, like, the sketch out and, like, the way things grow and have the layout pretty for everyone. It's kind of harder, but it can be worked out.
Now in 8th grade, these students were the original garden design and build team.
They were in teams of 3 or 4, and they came up with the design. They did have the option of using Google SketchUp as well for their plants, and then they created a kind of like an online website or portfolio that the 10th graders viewed, and then they decided on what would be the best design.
To turn Bermuda grass into gardens, fellow 7th graders dug it too. All shoveled in real life science lessons.
I realized that I could teach ecology, I could teach a decay of biomass in a compost bin, I could teach photosynthesis, homeostasis, all of these through gardening.
And while composting, we're stirring a lot of it, and it'll break down more.
I think it's really cool that we got to learn like this. Like, you know, in a lot of schools, you get to learn about, you know, the biology and the anatomy of plants through textbooks and stuff. But I think it was really cool that we got to do, like, you know, hands-on projects to be able to, like, you know, actually build stuff.
Their plant selection cultivated science of the senses.
I was thinking about having the flower living rose, and I thought about how the teachers have stress a lot every day, so when they come out here, they would see the living roses.
They learned how to combine native and well-adapted plants in a pleasing design year-round. To salute their school colors, blue and white, they included plumbago.
I designed the garden and also thought about what plants or vegetable that we can put into the garden. So I thought a lot about that and kind of like organized the whole thing and like draw it out.
I really like to be able to eat like the fresh fruits and vegetables. So that's one reason why I like to garden. And then another reason was that I really like to just kind of get my hands dirty and, you know, be able to say I did this and have an accomplishment. And I really like that.
And just knowing that they don't need as much stuff as if you had just picked a random plant off the internet. We researched throughout these plants, and they're well, like, thought of, I guess you could say, and I just love the color. They're so vibrant, and they're really pretty.
We had to space them in a special way. The bigger plants wouldn't cover up the smaller ones, and to make sure that they were all easily exposed to the sun. Like, for our tree, we had to space around it to make sure that we didn't have anything too close to, like, the roots, because the tree roots are also going to be very big.
To connect with the insect food chain, they avoid pesticides, especially since they planted to support pollinators.
I come from, like, Asia, so we look a lot about plants and see how the medicine comes into place. Because, you know, like, medicine here, sometimes it's bad for your liver, so I thought, like, we, like, prevent from these diseases. We eat these plants that we plant ourselves without, like, pesticide and stuff. And it's, like, all natural.
Austin Watershed donated most of the native plants, along with instruction about water collection and runoff. Not every plant is native, but they're just as resilient.
When you look around, you can just see that every plant here has adapted to the Texas weather. And so it's not like every plant has to be watered on a daily basis.
We decided to use rainwater because we felt that if we use reusable water, it would be better for our garden. That, and we didn't want to really waste water.
Since we're not using pesticides and fertilizers, whenever it does rain, and we've been kind of getting some flash flooding recently, so you could tell that the water would go straight off into our creeks and then into our aquifers. If we don't use pesticides, it'll keep our creeks clean.
Most importantly, these young makers are learning the most important lesson ever.
We are a maker school. We don't fail, we just redo. And the whole idea is to build that resiliency in our students, that you can fall on your knees, but you can get up, brush them off, and learn how not to fall the next time. So with this whole maker mentality that we have, you know, you're gonna create, and then you're gonna retool, and then you're gonna make, and then you might have to undo to redo after you reflect on how to improve. And that's what happened with the little floating porch, is that they'd seen the design, they came out and made it. You know, they didn't have really specifications on how to do that, but they were being creative and they said, oh, that doesn't work, let's redo. So our girls really are accustomed to redoing. That's really important in life.